All right, I'm going to be painting some coreopsis today in front of the penstemon, that red penstemon. And I begin by just blocking in my flowers. I like to paint flowers first and leaves last, usually, on my flowers. The reason I do this is because if I painted the greens first, when I came back and painted the flowers, my brush would pick up the green and it would make the flower color dirty. So normally I come in and I paint my flowers first, or just block them in. I really don't finish painting them. You'll see when I get a little further along. There are some flowers that are exceptions, but the majority of flowers I do this way. If they clump, like see these make a clump. So like daylilies or irises, I go ahead and paint the foliage first and then I come back and paint the flowers, but those are exceptions. And I walk around the side of the canvas and I want to cover this gallery wrap edge. Bring some little flowers over here. And I painted the flowers behind. I painted the penstemon first so that then I can paint these over it and I can come back up over the greens of the penstemon, so it looks like these are popping up in front of the flowers behind them. It would be hard to paint these first and then go back and try to paint those around it. So now I'm going to start bringing in the foliage. And my greens are mixes of phthalo blue and lemon yellow. And they give me a brighter, more intense green. The green behind that is made of phthalo blue plus cadmium orange plus white. So it's a duller green. So again, this helps to give depth to the painting. Muted colors go back. Brighter, more intense colors come forward. And this is also warmer than that color too, so that also helps it to come forward. And then I also have a little bit of a mixture of phthalo blue plus liquin. And I just like to put this in the depths of the foliage because that just helps give that feeling that there's some darkness back in there. And I do bring a few brush strokes of just phthalo blue plus white into that foliage, also to just give some coolness in them. Because when you look at bushes, there's leaves back underneath and the leaves underneath and the shadows are going to be cooler. And I work around my yellow. I will come back and accentuate the flowers. But right now I'm just getting the canvas covered. And I'm going to let my foliage, my little leaves, come down over those rocks. These flowers are growing out of some crevices in the rocks, but then the flowers kind of come over, scrape over a little bit on the rocks, and they're getting hit. There's just, the sunlight's coming in from the right, and so a little shaft of light's just hitting those rocks and bouncing across and then landing on these flowers. So I add a few little lights into the foliage, but I'm not going to add much because the majority of this clump is going to be in shadow. I want that to be a dark so that that keeps my eye, keeps the viewer's eye from going on off the canvas. So we go ahead and start bringing this foliage into shadow. Get darker. Again, these are, the lighter mix of this green is the phthalo blue plus lemon yellow plus a little bit of white to make it lighter. But now I'm just working with the pure phthalo blue plus lemon yellow. I've got two shades of that. One has more yellow in it, the other has more blue, just to give me some variation in the foliage. And I just very quickly, very roughly block in that foliage. I want it to be pretty loose and just, I don't go back in and delineate each and every little leaf. I'm walking around the camera, so if my voice kind of fades in and out, you'll see, but or you'll understand why. Okay, I'm going to bring a little more flowers over onto the side of the canvas. Just bring some of that yellow around, and then I'll work around it. Painting the green around the blocks of yellow helps to shape those blossoms. This gives them a little definition. I want to get the canvas completely covered. Paint this pretty thickly. It'll take a while for this to dry, but my canvas is attached to that cardboard, so that makes it really easy to move. And I just put some screw eyes into the back of the stretcher bars, and then they poke through the canvas and where they've or through the cardboard, and where they poke through, then I put a nail through there, and that holds the canvas onto the cardboard. And I can even ship this painting wet that way. And it arrives, by the time it arrives, it's usually dry to touch. And the gallery can take it off the backing board, hang it on the wall, and hopefully sell it very quickly. But this one is not going to be shipped. My collector actually lives not too far away, so they bought and commissioned the painting out of our Santa Fe gallery. But they actually live not far from me, so they're going to come pick it up. I don't usually get the pleasure of personally delivering or personally having collectors pick my paintings up. So that's really a fun to do. And it's when they come, I'll have the painting up on the easel, so when they walk in the door, they get to see their new baby. Now I'm back working on the yellow, and we're going to put a few little just petals kind of fall to the ground here and there. They'll get caught down in between these rocks. You rarely see flowers without a few petals here and there. There's going to be a lighter one up there in the sun. Now we're ready to add the centers in these coreopsis. And I'm using a mixture of my mud, which is ultramarine blue plus alizarin crimson. And then I mix some liquid in it to make it a little bit thinner. And I just start putting in the centers of my flowers. And I wipe my brush, keep it clean. I can usually do two or three flowers. Time, but this kind of start defining where my flowers are going to be. But you can see with the greens painted around them, it kind of lets me have my flower shapes. I'll work around the edge of the canvas in a minute. Let me go ahead and get these in the front done. I add some little stems. Now that I have the centers in the flowers, I know that where the stems will go. And I may come back, I'll have to add like a center on that one. I'll make two flowers out of that. The coreopsis are a fairly small flower. Now on the other side, we're going to have Indian paintbrush, and they're a bigger flower. But these little ones are littler. I guess is a good way to say it. Now to highlight my petals, I come back in. Now this is tricky. You kind of have to just lay the paint on top of the wet paint underneath. Because if you do your brush really heavy, then you pull up that paint underneath and you get your flowers all get dirty. So we want our flowers to stay crisp and cream.
crisp and clean.
It's a tongue twister. Yeah, I'm going to put a center there. And where was it? I said I was going to do two flowers. There it is. This is a place where you really have to keep your brush clean. Get these flowers. Now once I move out of the light area, I'll start coming in with a little bit of a darker yellow. And I've mixed, and this is pure lemon yellow is what I use to highlight my flowers. Now for the darker yellow flowers, I've added a little mud and a little cadmium orange into the mixture. And that just puts that yellow into shadow. And that's like down in here. Just a little darker. Now some of these down here are going to catch a little light just on the edge. They won't catch the whole flower, but just a little light. This one will be part in shadow and then part in light. I'll have to go back in and do that center again, but you just work back and forth. Okay, I'm about out of time on this one. My camera will only let me go so long. So we'll stop for now and I'll show you the second part in a minute.